Hi, my name's Richard Chambry. This is Rich Photo Books. It's a sequence of photo vlogs that I'm making about photo books, recommendation, reviews, and they're all hosted on YouTube. So please go to my YouTube channel, subscribe. Today's book is London Photographs by Terence Donovan. He was one of the Trinity, David Bailey, Brian Duffy, Terence Donovan in the 60s. Three photographers who made a big impact, and I followed almost immediately. They were sort of, their names were pushed right forward to me. Go look at these people. They are the best. So, and Terence Donovan, fantastic photographer. They're all East End boys. If you're not familiar with the East End of London. So they came from a little bit of hardship and made really good and broke into the fashion world, which was part of the establishment at the time. So people from their backgrounds wouldn't have necessarily got in there. And they were, as you can see, first couple of images, the quality and like how fantastic Terence Donovan's work was, you know, a real step ahead of people that have been in that game for donkey's years. He really brought some sort of fresh air into that, as did David Bailey and Brian Duffy too. And I really love it. What I loved especially was the quality, the shooting on medium format. That really interested me about Terence Donovan. Also, I used to see him on the television a lot, spinning around London in his Rolls Royce. So that was quite interesting. I seem to remember it being a white roller. And but hey, times change. I don't want a Rolls Royce. This is from a photo essay that he shot again on 2¼ square, black and white, really, really fantastically lit. Everything is about quality, lighting, and also the post-production, the printing, and how he looked after his photography after it had come out of the camera. I love this kind of stuff that he was shooting. This was for Vogue. Sir George Salty, he's a conductor back in the day. And he was shooting quite a lot of advertising. That was obviously funding the Rolls-Royce addiction. But yeah, he was shooting a lot of advertising, obviously, because he was, you know, fantastic. He was able to create some fantastic imagery. Let me just flick through to this next portrait because I love this. This is Kenneth Williams, if you're familiar with the Carry On movies, and with his mother. Now, he had a famously close relationship with his mother. He was incredibly funny, but also a loner. And there's something quite friendly about this picture. Kenneth Williams always came across on the television as being quite acerbic and quite, obviously, subsequently after his death, reading about how much of a loner he was and how anti-people he was. He just wasn't a real people person, considering he was an actor. So this was a real, I thought that was a really great portrait. He managed to get a bit of life out of him. Let's just go to this image here, which is my favourite. Okay, this is Sir Norman Wisdom. That's just a real beauty of a portrait. If you're not familiar with Norman Wisdom's movies, he's very frenetic and very loud, shouty, and there's a real pain and sadness about him in this image. This is you know, what I think he was best at. Terry Donovan, he had a real connection with people. I think he was able to really get the best out of them for a portrait. I just wanted to finish off with this image. There he is, there's Terence. That was published just after his death in 1996. It was a sad time when he died fairly young, really. I just wanted to go back here because I found an image where this was interesting. It was a black belt in judo and was a real martial arts expert. And I found that quite interesting. I did judo back then And to read that Terry Donovan was some sort of champion, that was pretty cool. And I knew from reading that he was heavily into that. So, just to give you a quick review on this book, fantastic book to go get hold of. Gives you a good perspective. It's not a massive book, as you can see, and won't cost much money to go get. So I'm going to put up some links underneath this video. Go click them. Go find the book. I'll put up some links on Terry Donovan's where his work is, so you can go and check that out. And if you'd like to subscribe to this channel, please do click subscribe right underneath if you're on YouTube. And please do go follow me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. I do put these videos out or put clips up, and you can sort of follow me in that world on those social platforms, and that'll bring you into maybe watch the odd video or two on the Rich Photo Books vlogs. So thanks ever so much for watching again, and go get this book.